friends, this is Nirmal here for Technique, and in this video we are going to compare two mid-range phones, the Lenovo's YK5 Note with the Leica LA2. So these two phones are almost priced similarly, 11999 for the base variant of the Lenovo YK5 Note, and LA2 also is priced 11999, and they have a lot of similarities in terms of specifications as well. Both have full HD 5.5 inch displays, they offer 3GB RAM, 32GB internal storage. Then you also have Android 6.0 Marshmallow on these two phones as well. But they also differ in some other aspects, like the processor. It's a Helio P10 octa-core chipset on the YK5 Note, while on the other hand, the LA2 comes with a powerful Snapdragon 652 octa-core chipset. And the battery capacity is also different. We have 3500 on the Lenovo's YK5 Note, while it's 3000 on the LA2. Now the camera also, there is a difference. We have a 13 megapixel shooter on the K5 Note, while it's a 16 megapixel shooter on the Leica. Now we'll go into the detailed aspects about these two phones. So first step, let's have a look at the design and build quality. Now in terms of the design and build quality, both these devices have metallic construction. You can see it's a unibody design. Both have really good build quality. Now it's a tough choice selecting one of these two devices in terms of the build quality, because both are really good. The LA2 feels a bit more sturdier than the YK5 Note, but we feel the finishing on the YK5 Note is slightly more premium than the LA2. But again, it's a subjective thing. It depends upon user to user. So we don't really have a clear winner in terms of the design and build quality, but we would say both these devices exhibit really great build quality, and design also feels pretty good. Now let's move on to the display. Here both these phones come with a 5.5 inch full HD display, and the display quality on both these phones are really good. If you see the viewing angles and the touch spots, both are really good. They have great colors, punchy colors, the sharpness levels are also pretty good. The Lenovo's YK5 Note has been improved when compared to the previous versions of K4 Note and K3 Note, and come with great color quality as well. The LA2 also comes with a great display quality. Now both these phones do not offer any added protection on the display. There is no mention of any added protection on either of these two devices, so we advise readers to use a protective film in case you are worried about scratches and other damages to the screen. So display quality, again, both these devices are equally good and offer great quality in terms of display performance. Now let's move on to the software. So both these phones have Android 6.0 Marshmallow, again similar, but then the software, the UI is quite different. One we have the Vibe UI, the other one we have the EUI. So first let's talk about the Vibe UI. So Vibe UI has almost dock-like experience. We have an app drawer, multiple home screens are not there included. It comes with an app drawer, and it is very similar to the Android 6.0 interface. So you can see here we have the settings panel, again very similar. It also comes with added features like Quick Snap, Knock to Light, Smart Scene. We have fingerprint gestures, VR mode. So a lot of additional features are there included, and this also comes with Theater Max feature, which along with VR provides a great experience. There is also Dolby Atmos support, so the quality of music is also really good. Now you can see the customized notification center and quick toggles, again they are customizable, and it also offers some themes. Although there are no themes to download, we have some basic themes available where you can customize the lock screen, the dialer and other options. So it's a feature rich UI, definitely one of the good UIs available right now in this category. It comes with app drawer, so that's one good thing. A lot of Chinese OEMs now have only multiple home screens and are devoid of an app drawer, so that's where the Vibe UI comes handy, because if you love the stock-like experience, the Vibe UI is much closer to the stock-like experience. Now talking about the UI on the Leica LA2, it's a EUI, which again comes with a custom settings. You can see the customized settings. We also have some added features, and there is also some support for themes, but theme support is very limited, similar to the K5 Note. We have some default themes which you can customize, but there are no options to download added themes, although there are some online themes, again very limited, not like Xiaomi's MIUI. So but then a decent amount of customizations are included. Again, this phone comes with IR blaster, so you can use this phone as remote control for your TV, AC, and DTH. All those things are included. So that's one added feature. This phone also comes with a Dolby Atmos support. So again, the quality of music is quite good. Now the UI is it's not very user friendly, because if you have not used EUI previously, we have this control center which is different from stock like Android. We have, if you press multitasking, the multitasking option is implemented in a different manner. We have the quick toggles, then added apps are also included. So it's a quite different UI, but once you get used to the UI, it's a quite useful UI, but then it does not have any resemblance to the stock Android. Now talking about the performance. So this is one area the LUT 2 outperforms the K5 Note. The LUT 2 comes with the Snapdragon 652 octa-core chipset, while we have the Helio P10 octa-core chipset on the K5 Note. Now here is a look at the benchmark scores of these two phones, and you can clearly see the winner here. The Snapdragon 652 is a really powerful chipset, which is already shown by the benchmark scores, and not just the benchmark scores, it's really powerful chipset, excellent gaming performance. And altogether, the LUT 2 with the Snapdragon 652 is a great performer. On the other hand, the K5 Note is a decent performer. The gaming experience was just average. It will not match up with the performance offered by the LUT 2. So all in all, we would say in terms of the performance, the LUT 2 is a clear winner. Definitely great performance in terms of the gaming, day-to-day task as well. But the Helio P10 isn't a great device for gaming, but day-to-day task, it definitely works very well. And there's also 4GB RAM variant available for 13500 for the K5 Note. So in terms of the software and performance, we would say software, it's a mixed bag. If you love a stock like Android, it's a Vibe UI you should choose. But if you want a bit of different UI, similar to the iOS, then a UI offers something new. Now in terms of the performance, the clear winner is the LUT 2. Now apart from the performance aspect, both these devices are 4G LTE, dual SIM card capabilities, 32 gigs of storage. But the added feature for the K5 Note is that it also comes with a micro SD card expansion slot. Although it's a hybrid SIM card, you can definitely expand the storage, which is not possible on the LUT 2. Now let's move on to the camera. So here again there's a difference. We have a 30 megapixel shooter on the K5 Note with a face detection autofocus, while it's a 16 megapixel shooter on the LUT 2. So and the front facing camera is again both 8 megapixel. Now let's have a look at the camera interface. You can see that the LUT 2 offers added features in terms of the camera experience, and it also supports 4K video recording, which is not available on the K5 Note. On the other hand, the K5 Note camera interface is quite simple and does not offer any added features, but it does come with decent amount of options. Now let's have a look at the camera samples taken between these two devices, and here you can see that the K5 Note is the winner because it does provide a great camera experience. The camera samples look pretty good. There is good detailing, good sharpness levels, and colors are almost natural. But on the other hand, the LUT 2 is not that great in terms of the color quality. The sharpness, we feel it's a bit over sharpened, leading to noise levels increasing in the LUT 2. So in terms of the overall performance, even in low light, you can see that the LUT 2 disappoints when compared to the K5 Note. So in terms of the camera performance, we would say the K5 Note is a winner. Even in a front facing camera, we feel that natural colors are exhibited by the K5 Note, although the LUT 2 also provides a decent selfie experience. Now video recording, again a K5 Note, we would say in the 1080p sample, the K5 Note was a winner. But if you are looking for 4K, then LUT 2 is the only option available. So in terms of the camera experience, we would say K5 Note is our personal choice in terms of the overall clarity and color quality. Now finally, the battery performance. So both these phones have a pretty good capacity battery, 3500 on the K5 Note, while it's 3000 mAh on the LUT 2. Now in terms of the camera battery performance, both these devices are quite good, and you can easily get one day of usage with both these devices because it comes with Android 6.0 Marshmallow. Now added feature for the LUT 2 is that it comes with the fast charging and USB-C type port, which could be the latest technology. So that's one added feature about these two devices. Overall, we feel in terms of the battery performance, the K5 Note has a slight edge, but then the LUT 2 has fast charging. So it's a mixed bag in terms of the battery performance. Now we have talked about almost all aspects. Now we'll see some other aspects like the fingerprint scanner. Here both these devices have great fingerprint scanner. They work pretty fast, no major issues, and they're quite fast and responsive as well. Now, one of the added features about the Lerto is the LerVD app, which provides a lot of movies. They're partnered with Eros now, so you get a lot of movies, Bollywood movies and regional movies. That's one good aspect. So that is not available on the K5 Note. So if you love watching a lot of multimedia content, then the Lerto is a good experience. Apart from that, the Lerto comes with USB-C type earphones, so that's something new offered. And if you want to listen to great quality music, the USB-C type earphones provide a better experience than the standard 3.5mm audio jack. But the downside is that there is no earphones provided with this device, and you have to buy the USB-C type earphones, which is priced almost 2K. Now, in terms of sound quality, we would say the speaker output, we would say the K5 Note is a better choice because it has a better output if you're looking for better speaker performance. So these were the comparison aspects about these two phones. So which is a better device to buy, considering that both these devices have 3GB RAM variant priced at 11999? So it's a mixed choice. If you're looking for outright performance, then obvious choice is the Lerto. But if you're looking for an overall all-round performance from your device, the Lenovo's Vibe K5 Note could be the better choice, because apart from the outright performance in terms of gaming, camera, battery life, software, all these things are quite good on the K5 Note. And it also has this added micro SD card expansion slot. Even though it's a hybrid SIM card, you can expand the 32 gigs of internal storage, but that is not possible on the Lerto. But the Lerto has added advantage that it has a great performance, great gaming experience, USB-C type port, fast charging, and also USB-C type earphones. So these are some of the options which we feel will help you deciding between these two devices. So you have to set your priorities. There is no one better device out of these two. If you want performance, go for Lerto. If you're looking for camera and anything else, then the K5 Note is a better choice. So that was a detailed comparison of these two phones. If you plan to buy either of these devices, we have the link in the description. You can use our link and buy the devices. That helps our channel. So that's all, guys, with the comparison. Hope you liked this video. Don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.